I'm going to show you how to use this auth token to authorize yourself with our API. The way that this will work in a real app is the client-side app will make a HTTP request to our login endpoint with the username and password that it wants to authenticate. So a user will enter their email address and password. The app will then call the API login endpoint, and then our backend will confirm that that username and password is valid. If it is valid, then we'll generate a temporary token and we'll return that token to the user. The app is then responsible for ensuring that that token is included in all future HTTP requests. It does this by adding the token to the HTTP headers for all the future requests it makes. A HTTP header is like a metadata that goes along with the HTTP request. So it's data about the request. In that data, there's something called an authorization HTTP header. This authorization HTTP header will include our token. Then every time the app makes a request to our API, we can check if it's provided a valid token in the HTTP headers. If the token's valid, we can perform the request. If it's invalid, then we can return a 401 unauthorized response. If the app receives a 401 unauthorized response, then it can then redirect the user back to the login page, and then they can log in again to generate a new token. I'm going to show you how to simulate adding the HTTP headers to our requests using a Chrome extension called ModHeader. You should have installed ModHeader at the beginning of this course. If you didn't, then please go back to the earlier lessons and install that now, because we're going to need it for the rest of this course. The way that ModHeader works is once it's installed into Chrome, it gives you this little blue icon here. If you click on the blue icon, it gives you this nice window that we can use to add custom HTTP headers to our request. Before we add any HTTP headers, I'm going to add something called a filter. The filter is going to ensure that the HTTP headers only apply to this specific web page that we're testing. The reason I want to do that is because I've had experiences in the past where I've forgotten that ModHeader is still running and it's broken other websites that I've visited, and it took me a long time to figure out why. So then now I always add a filter to make sure the HTTP headers are only applied to the web page that I'm testing. Click on the plus symbol here and then click on filter to add a new filter. We're going to add a filter that matches any website that contains this 127.0.0.1 and then colon 8080. So I'm going to add */*127.0.0.1 colon 8080 *. So the star is a wildcard, so it will match any text before and any text after, but it will match all the pages that have /*127.0.0.1:8080 in it. So now that we've added that, we can go and add our authorization header. So in the name of this header here, let's type authorization with a capital A. This is the name of the header field that we're adding. In the value of the field, we're going to start by typing token and then a space, and then we're going to go and paste the contents of our token. So add a space and then paste the contents of our token. This is how you add the HTTP header to all the HTTP requests using ModHeader. That's all we need to do to add the token. So now we can go ahead and test our authorization. Make sure that this box is checked here to make sure so that the header is enabled, and then click back on the web page. I'll go back to our API route and head over to the profile page. So we're currently logged in as the, or we should have logged in as the super user that we created at the beginning, which is this one here with ID 1. So head over to /profile/1 to see the detail view. And you can see that we now have the option to modify this user. So let's go ahead and test that. Let's modify it to Mark Winterbottom 1 and make sure we enter the password, awesome1, and click put. You can see that it's updated the page. So how do we log out? How do we test once we've logged out of the API? Well, if you click on the mod header again and you uncheck this box and go back and refresh the page, or don't refresh it because then it's going to post again. Just click on the address bar here and hit enter to reload. And you can see that now the edit option has disappeared. That's because we're no longer authorized with our API. Let's put it back. So turn on the authorization again, and then again, reload the page. And you can see that it comes back. So let's go back to our user profile list and see what happens when we visit another user's profile that we're not logged in as. So if we use this profile ID number 2 here and hit enter, you can see that we're not able to modify profile number 2. That's because our permissions class says that we can only modify the user that we're logged in as. So if you go back to number 1, you'll see that we can modify this. Okay, so it looks like our authentication and login API is working. Let's go ahead and commit our changes to Git. Minimize Chrome and load up the Git bash and navigate to the profile's REST API location. Type git add dot to add the files, and then type git commit hyphen am and give it a message, added login API. And hit enter to commit. So that's how you test the login API. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.